to, I don't know, I'm talking this politics lately and I don't want to do the politics. I don't enjoy them. As soon as I left France, it's no fun. I don't really like politics here in the US, so I'm not, it's just taking the joy out of my little reign. My reign, la reine de France. Anyway, so I'm here at this mosaic land. The migrants, are they migrants? No. They're marching towards the border from Guatemala, like 1,000 people or something, and they're already here. And I'm like, well, chances are, even if they come across, the city probably will just absorb them, you know what I mean? Because it's only 1,000 people or 2,000 people. They probably won't even notice. Maybe all the little menial labor jobs will be taken away real quick. That type of thing. But yeah, I mean the answer, because it's 1 or 2,000 people, is like you go like Limoges and you put up a factory and make some really neat, interesting pottery that is just here to this indigenous native land, and maybe even with a Guatemalan twist, and they can make some interesting pottery, you know, and they can sell it all around the world. So, but then, you know, I don't really want a factory nearby, so maybe leave it over there on the other side of the border. And the other side of the border is cheaper, so, you know, maybe in preference live on that side. It's much cheaper. They're not gonna like property tax on this side. It's gonna be a rough, you know, so I'm saying Limoges pottery creation, and stay over there in the Juarezian, who knows, land, okay? And maybe come over here for a visit and go, well, yuck, it's double, triple, quadruple the price. Why would I want to live here? I mean, the money on the wages is really not so great. As we've all seen, the wages have not increased in preference to what the corporations are earning. That was something I saw recently. They had that line, here are the wages, and then here's what the corporation is earning. Yeah, one of those. Anyway, so I'm deep into these mosaics, and so I'm really into ceramic talk at the moment. I also got glass, and so I'm snapping, and, you know, I'm making all the cuts, trying to, I don't know, make them tiny. So what happens is they're brand new at first, you know, there's a slab of it. This was 48 cents. And then I snap it into a whole bunch of pieces. I actually whacked it with like a hammer. I went with that method first for this style. And you just wear a glove and then you hit it with a hammer with some glasses on. And it was such a show me, isn't it? We're all from Missouri, I guess. Show me. Anyway, so you take this mosaic. And then eventually it's going to go on top of mortar. I'm not doing the dry dust bath mortar way because it's kind of scary to me. I'm gonna just do the regular, and I can't find enough of the how-tos, so I'm just gonna do regular mortar place, and then maybe on as the stick is stuck in there, I'll do like a grout mortar with maybe a color tone. Gosh dang it, my leg is falling asleep, like all the way up, probably to my neck. This is no fun. Gosh dang it. It's true. Even as I'm walking around, I'm asleep all the way up to my neck. I don't know what it is. You know? It's just life, I guess. I hit 50 plus now, and not in my kilos, but in, well, maybe those also, but in the years, and it's just, I'm just like, what do you call it? Call me the numb lady. It's like somebody gave me an epidural and it doesn't go away. Yeah. Anyway, oh, maybe aliens from outer space. That's it. Aliens. They hijacked me into one of those. Since I'm an Indian, since I'm an altoplano. Ooh. I am an alto plano. Since I'm one of those, they would have been interested. And a royal. Ooh, a royal all the way straight from Egypt and Constantine. Yes, they want to know more about her. So they would have sucked me into their ship. Taken, who was that one guy? He made a video. It was so funny. And it really stuck in my brain. You know, the crash. It was he crashed his car in the video, and then from there he was sucked into an alien spaceship, and then they spit him out and just dropped him off somewhere at the airport, and the leaves were blowing right and the leaves were blowing left, and that was what I got out of it anyway, but it was kind of funny. My drama is these massive, speaking of these 2000, I wanna be in America. Well, my gosh, they have some really gross tile colors. I got this one as blue, but it's not really my favorite blue. And I had to get the glass just to compensate. And it's like brown, and then beige, and then gray, and then brown, and then beige, and then gray again. And there's these two superstores, and they just make millions and millions every year. And they only give us, the Altiplanos here, they only give us brown. And oh my gosh, one store actually gave me blue. I got the blue choice. So, and so I asked the guy, I said, where can we get these colors? And he's like, well, there's a... Actually, I didn't ask him that point blank. I said, where's another tile store? And how boring of me, I know. But it's like 25 miles away. And maybe there's some colors. And anyway, I didn't want to drive 50 miles to get some color, so here I am stuck with this blue. So woo woo, I don't know, coming to America is not such a great idea if all you're stuck with is this blue and beige and brown, because this is still the land of Altiplano Indians, Navajos and Aztecs. So we are not, don't forget Apache. So because of all of this is going down, I don't think they give us good choices here. I think you have to go to maybe Colorado or Missouri. Yeah. Anyway, how sad. I'm sad that they feel that, that this was the answer. Because in my mind, I want to go to Guatemala. I don't want to be here. So I don't get the switch, you know. Why would they think, you know, lifestyles of the rich and famous, they're gonna be on celebrity TV, they're gonna be in Hollywood, you know, $50 million mansion. And I think those are horrible houses. Have you seen some of them? They're just horrible. They're terrible architecture. They're just nouveau crud and tract, homie. And they're, and yet they're $80 million. Very, very terrible, terrible design in all of their decadence. Yeah, so anyway, so they're here and they're piling up at the border, more and more of them, you know. Like, there is some panacea here, some fruit different, when the fruit here is the one from Guatemala. We get our bananas from there. I'm sad for them because they think it's better. Anyway, I wrote to the tax man of the county. I think he was the tax man. Yeah. I wrote him a complaint, and that's all you can do is lodge complaints here. So I'm not really sure what all this freedom is all about. I can lodge a complaint, and they don't have to answer me back. They can delete it. So what's the freedom? What is that freedom all about? I can lodge a complaint. Anyhoot, I mean, in Mexico, no guns. No guns are allowed. You get put in prison. Isn't that great? Fabulous. Because then there wouldn't be any of these shootings. So, you can say, follow Mexico, la 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 la, but they're not. Instead, they push people to buy guns because the justice system is skewed to give, you know, give information about people, so they're not protected. And so the baddies go and they hurt them. So people have to buy guns to protect themselves. Because these government, what are they calling, like databases? They just give a whole bunch of your private information away for free. And so then the person is not protected. So they have to arm themselves here in America. We have to have guns. We have to have guns in our house because that bad person that you once knew may come back after you. So you have to protect yourself. It's that horrible. They divulge, they give. And because they're doing that, they support the gun industry, they support the weapons industry. They're not protecting the population that pays taxes. They're not protecting those people. Yeah, anyway. So, here I am in the world of blue. And I'm not really sure why. My God, the weather here is terrible. Even here, I'm on the south of this heavy United States. And it's cold. all my tomatoes have turned green and frozen. They didn't get a chance to go red. So why come here? The tomatoes are all frozen. You know, when we look at reasons, it just doesn't make any sense. It does not make any sense. What people expect out of life, you know? Get here, get in the house, and start building, you know, building and building and building and going and going and going. And go to work every day and then go back home and sit and watch a sitcom, you know. That, and then, oh yeah. And then once or twice a week you get to go to McDonald's or Carl's Jr. You know, big America. Freedom. Meanwhile, the people are yelling in the streets, in riots, and saying impeach the president, and they're unhappy. You can have all the Democrats all of a sudden now put in the House of the Representative, and now you got the Senate now controlled by Republicans, so now they're gonna go kissy kissy, no, I wanted this, I wanted this, and so never the twain shall meet. So nothing is going to be accomplished for 2 years. Okay. Unless the kissy-kissy Republican senators and the kissy-kissy president get together. That's how it gets accomplished. Because they're Republicans. They can trump that little House of Representatives in many instances. So, I was like, what? No, this is not a democracy. We all know this. This is a republic. And the US government is a corporation. It is not anything but a corporation, and I believe it says that. It's stated that somewhere in the papers of all of these, what do we call them, doctrines and articles. Somewhere it states it that it's just a corporation, a business. It's a business. That manufactures, it manufactures weapons, it manufactures flying weapon machines, it manufactures sailing weapon machines, ocean-worthy weapon machines. It's a weapons maker. That's who our U.S. government corporation is. Okay. I don't know. I don't want to really talk about the fires and 200 people are missing. I don't want to talk about that. There's nothing I can do. If they're gone, they're gone. It's terrible. It's a terrible thing to be missing, isn't it? To go missing, because without the bones there's really no real true conclusion, is there? Without that sift of ashes and the data, there's no true conclusion. So it's going to be a real yucky forensic, anything over there in the Sierras. Anyhoot. Now you all know I am the mummy dog woman. I'm the accident maker of three dogs, three Samoyeds when I was a child. They were all killed at my accident. I left the door open. I divulged that a couple days ago. That was difficult for me. I think that's the most personal thing I've ever said. That's very difficult. They died. And my mother, my loving mother, they were her show dogs. They were Samoyeds, huskies. She wrapped them. She stripped the sheets as fast as she could. And she wrapped the dogs in the sheets, all around each leg, around their heads, their tails, everything. They were wrapped, they were turned into mummies without, you know, that type where they suck through the head and take out the brain. She turned them into mummies, and then we drove, me and my brothers and my father. We drove and drove and drove and drove until we found a place to bury them. And they were all buried. They were all dug deep into a grave area. Quite morbid, isn't it, my childhood? My mother was just, she just had to make drama extra over the dogs dying. But yeah, they dug deep. I don't know, it was maybe 5 feet even for my sweeties. They were the same little dogs. They were show stage, but they were the same dogs that I delivered with my little brother in the back of a truck while at a bar mitzvah. My family was at a bar mitzvah, but we weren't. We were kind of kicked out, and then when we were kicked out, the dogs started giving birth. So it worked out. It worked out. We were very young giving birth in the back of that International. It was an old International. Oh my God. And I believe you can do that in any country in the world. You know, it's nothing American. It's nothing amazing extra to be here. So back to the mummies, yeah. So they're there in those Oakland Hills, San Francisco Bay Area. I believe they're under somebody's house. I think they built a house over them by now. And I've always wondered, do the people who live there, do they have dreams? You know, do the dogs drift through, you know, and give them dreams? You know, wolf dreams, husky dreams, running dreams. I just wonder if they weave through. Anyway, that was a smile on me, wow. Anyway, like I said on my little blog there, my gosh, reason for my family to hate me forever, wasn't it? Who let the dogs out? It was me. I did it. Right there in Oakland. Anyway. That's it. That's all I have. And yeah, people cry on this side of the border just like they cry on the other. People hate on this side just like they hate on the other. I don't see the difference. Aside from, well, maybe the water might be cleaner. Sometimes the water, you know, you could say that. Maybe we have better water processing. I'm not going to say better schools. Yell.